Gender identity typically develops in stages around age 2. It's certainly true, thanks to growing acceptance from parents, doctors, and peers, young people with gender dysphoria are becoming increasingly comfortable coming out of the closet and transitioning. There is, however, a difference between gender dysphoria and gender identification, and it's the latter that can fan out across the population as more young people become comfortable with the language, nuances, and politics of gender.
Welcome back to my channel. My name is Scout, and today we're going to be looking at something different. Now, I know that I don't usually delve into other topics, but I did come across one that kind of sparked something in me that I think I would like to address. And just before we get into anything, I just want to say that I am not doing this or talking about this to like attack anyone or hurt anyone's feelings. I know it's very sensitive and controversial topic. This is just my own opinion about it, and my opinion isn't like fact or anything. I know I'm probably gonna get some people saying
like, this isn't your business to talk about, you shouldn't be talking about this, like leave them alone, like it's just a kid.
And I'll explain why in a minute, but when you put yourself out there on the internet, you are going to be criticized. You're putting yourself out there and people are mean and they suck. And you're allowed to be criticized. There's no shield that you can hide behind. There's nothing that excuses you from criticism. Not race, not gender, not sexual orientation. Like, nothing excuses you from being criticized. And that is where I'm coming from. And again, I'm not talking about this because I hate trans people or I hate gay people. I don't hate anyone. But I think this is something that is very new, that has been kind of growing into more mainstream media over the past like decade or something, so I just want to talk about it. The channel that I found that I really want to talk about today is called Jonathan Jolie? I'm not really sure. And this channel isn't like all about the topic that I'm going to be talking about. It's not like a huge thing, but there's like, I've seen a lot of the shorts of this channel are a lot about this topic in particular, and the topic is childhood transgender ideation, like trans kids basically. And what my issue is I don't think a child, especially a child of this age that I'm about to show you, can like really wrap their, like can completely understand the whole complexity of wanting to transition into another gender. Now, I'm not saying that anyone, like being trans is bad. What I'm saying is when you're a kid, you can't consent to anything. You can't make decisions for yourself a lot of the times. It's like, you can't join the army. You can't vote. You can't consent. You can't do any of that until you're at least 18. So why do we think that they know whether or not they feel a boy or a girl, or like the opposite gender? Like, when I was this age, that wasn't even something I even really like thought about or noticed. Maybe like, oh look, the boys run faster than the girls, or you know, like really basic level stuff. And it just doesn't feel like something that a child would have the ability to make a decision on or feel a certain way. But now that like the media is way more affirming, kids are getting confused and being exposed to this like more and more earlier in their lives, and it's confusing them. And instead of their parents asking them like, oh, like why do you feel this way, like maybe we should talk to someone about this, they just start affirming them like, oh, you want to wear girl shoes, okay, you're a girl. And the kid doesn't really have much of a chance. And I'm not saying that, again, I'm gonna keep saying that, I'm not saying that trans is bad. If you're an adult, I think you can do whatever you want with your body, as long as it's not hurting yourself or others. But when you're a child, you are completely dependent on your parent, and a kid can't like make a decision like this without their parent. Do you see what I mean? It's like if their parent was like, no, you're not a girl, you're a boy, you were born a boy, we're gonna keep being a boy, the child would probably just be like, oh, okay, like, I'm not saying that's the way to handle it, but the kid can't do it themselves, you know? So I just wanted to kind of introduce the topic beforehand and how I feel about it, so. Okay, so the first one says, behind every worried trans child is a proud parent raising them up with love and support. And that's the other thing that bothers me about this, because all the accounts that I've seen, because this isn't the only account that I've seen of this, but every account that I've looked at so far, it's always the parent, like, showing off their trans child, who's probably, like, 5 or 6 or 7 or 8, like, somewhere in that range, like, younger than 10 years old, and being like, well,
I am, because I, like, did it closet with them, and I am so great and so awesome that I accepted them, and you guys are all monsters, you don't, because this is a child, like,
it's really hard to come up with a solution, because obviously you don't want a kid to be confused or feel like their needs aren't heard or that their worries or their confusions aren't, like, valid, you know? Because I'm sure media has made these kids so confused. But the parent is, like, almost, like, using this as a way to gain more attention. And I'm sure not every parent who accepts their child and transitions them like this is doing it because of, like, some ulterior motive, like, oh, we can get a lot of views, we can, like, kind of flaunting it, you know, like, or to show how great they are of a parent. Like, I don't think every parent is like that, but a lot of the examples I've seen, the kid is just doing what the parent tells them to do, like,
oh, just say how good daddy is to you.
And it's just kind of sickening to watch, because, you know, this, if the kid can't make a video by themselves, like, they don't know how.
How do they know what they want with their bodies?
You know what I'm saying?
Hear things and leave. There's the door. There's the door, bitch!
And that's the other thing about this channel that really bothers me, is that I'm sure they get hate, and I'm sure this child isn't treated always nicely by their peers, but to be like,
oh, you don't agree with it? You are gonna be mean to them? You're gonna be mean to them? Well, F you, stupid idiot, because you have to agree, otherwise you're a bigot.
Is it not okay to be concerned that a child this age is questioning their gender? I don't think it's a reason to celebrate. This is a kid. This is, like, probably not even maybe a third grader. I'm not even sure. I don't know Edie's age. It's really gross to me that this is the attitude that they've adopted to handle this sort of thing. Like, maybe instead of creating more enemies and just being like, F off, like, if you don't agree with us, and I'm not saying hate is good either. Like, you shouldn't hate on a kid. It's not the kid's fault. It is absolutely the parents. The parents influence the kid, and a child this age is completely dependent on their parents. So, I am not talking about the child and, like, what kind of person the child is. I am not attacking Edie. I don't want to seem like I'm attacking, but I'm just concerned, and I don't like this idea that a kid can make that decision, because they can't really understand, like, what entails of that sort of decision, because it's not just, oh, I get to wear dresses now and girl shoes and go and wear, like, long hair. Like, that's also not what it means to be a girl, but it's also, like, you're gonna have to deal with probably some social injustice. Like, people will probably be mean to you because you're different, and it's sad, and I'm never trying to say that we should hate on these people, but you are gonna probably face a lot of hardships, like going to the bathroom, going in locker rooms. It's gonna be a struggle, and you're gonna be influenced by a lot of things that a normal kid that doesn't have these problems would.
What do we have to do? We're told, but surely, because I was wearing girl shoes. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
And, like, that, you, every time it bothers me, because the dad is there, like, I'll lose calorie, but the dad is
there, like, so what'd you tell me? You told me they said you were a boy, but you're actually a girl, right? You're a girl. Say you're a girl.
It's a script. The kid is just being played by his parents, And I don't know them personally. I don't know what goes on behind the scenes, but I see what they post, and what they post, I don't think is a good thing or is a good message, because the child, it seems like very unsure about what he's saying. And the dad's just like literally in his face, like holding on to him, being like, yeah, uh-huh, okay. And say that, and I, like, do you know what I'm, it's just the way that they produce their content that makes me bothered by it, because there's a lot of reasons I'm bothered by it, but it's mainly because you can see how much influence the father has on the child, and how much the father thinks of himself, because he's allowed this to happen. And these children are so easily influenced.
Hi, my name is Edie. Being Edie is what I do. And if you have a problem with that, then who the F are you?
It's every video that, like, every video that they're responding to hate, it's the dad's in the background or up with the kid being like, yeah, yeah, you tell them what I told you. Like, and maybe the kid really did come to the dad and was like, I'm confused. Can you help me? I feel like I'm a girl. And I don't know how he handled that. I'm sure it wasn't easy. I would know. I have a trans family member, and it is very hard for me to deal with that. So I'm not just saying this as a person who wouldn't understand, because I do understand. I do get it. I'm not saying I get what it's like to be trans. I'm saying I know what it's like to be a family member who now has to also transition with the idea of that. But my sibling is an adult, so they are allowed to do whatever they want. But this is a child being influenced by their parent, and their parent is using them on their platform to show how great they are. In my opinion, this is what I'm getting from this. And maybe some people will say, like, oh, you're just being sensitive, like, leave them alone, it's just a kid, being a kid, let the kid be happy, this is obviously what he wants. How do you know that, though? How do you know? Because everything you see on social media is probably not true. And a kid, and like, how do you think what if he changes his mind? What if he goes back to me and, like, you know what? I was younger then. I was really heavily influenced by my parents. I was very strongly affirmed, but now I feel like I'd rather be a boy. What are his parents gonna do? Because that's like most of their channels, probably because of Edie. But without a trans child, what do you have, you know? And I'm not saying, like, Edie should be used, but it feels like Edie is being used for just clicks and views. Not so bad. It's not so bad. Who are you trying to talk to right now? Like, who is this for? And yes, I am sure people will comment on them and talk to them and tell them how to parent their kid. And yes, parents are allowed to parent their own kid and do what they want with their own kid as long as it doesn't harm anyone. But you're teaching your kid by example that this is how you treat other people when they don't agree with you. It's to just flip them off and be like, well, sucks to be you because I'm right and you're stupid and a bigot. I don't feel like on my channel, I, like, constantly talk down to, okay, maybe I talk down to haters, but I'm not, like, picking a fight with you. I always say I'd rather have a conversation, like, oh, like, why do you disagree with me? Let's have a conversation. Don't just say something stupid and unintelligent just to get a reaction out of me, because I'm not gonna, like, respond to it. Because, yes, I've had people disagree with me, but we've had conversations. I want to hear your side and share why I think what I think. And that doesn't mean either of us have to agree, but it's just like the respect and the maturity. And you're teaching your kid at a young age that because he's different, he'll get hate. And because of that hate, you should just react by flipping them off and, like, moving on. And maybe it's a good thing to teach your kid that, like, don't listen to the haters. But, like, this, I don't feel like is the way to teach your kid how to handle them. Because I think you should be teaching your kid people will not agree, because this is a very, very controversial topic. And if your kid knows what gender they feel like, then why wouldn't they be able to understand that why people wouldn't agree. Because you probably, this kid's probably just being told because you're different, because you're trans, people won't like you. But it's like, why is that? You know, why do people feel that way? What reason could they have to disagree? And I don't know if that child has ever been taught that lesson. And this is not teaching them that lesson, because I think Edie, if they can, he continues to feel this way throughout his life and up to adulthood, should learn more about, like, what it means to be transgender, of course, what it means to be a female, because obviously he'll never be a female, but if that's the way you still want to live, then good on you. If you're an adult, once you're an adult, that's fine. There's also a lot of gray areas being an adult transgender person, but that's not really a kid's arena, you know? It's a very murky topic. All of the comments on this video, everyone on, like, I've seen multiple videos, every video I check, it's people just saying, I'm so glad this is my parent, I'm so glad my parents raised me right. Like, let me see, slowly to find who the F switches the, Yeah, it's just like, at this age, I was, like, trying to close the refrigerator door and wondering why the lights would turn off. Like, all of these, and there's 54,000 comments on this video. It's just so disturbing to me that this child is just being taught that, oh, because you're trans, people are just mean. Like, anyone who disagrees is just mean. Like, but you should understand that your kid being trans isn't natural. Like, being transgender isn't natural. And evolutionary wise, and I'm not saying that we have to follow everything like evolutionary, because obviously men went out and hunted while women stayed home, and now that's not the same social norm we have today, so things will change. I know that, and I think that we're not going to be able to get rid of trans people. Like, that's not what I'm trying to say, but children cannot make that decision, and I think it's okay to still, like, support them, but not to the point where you're just like, okay, oh, you're just, the kid tried on some girl's shoes, I guess they want to be a girl. And I know that's not the case everywhere, but it kind of boils down to the kid just being like, you know, I kind of want to wear a dress, and you just say, okay, go for it, you know.
Skip to the good part.
You've arrived at your destination.
I'm a girl!
Maybe this does make Edie happy. And I hope it does. But I just don't think Edie will understand it completely because of how old he is. And Edie is not, like, I don't know. I'm just trying to say, I'm not trying to blame Edie for any of this, because the media will make kids confused now. It's too easy to target them and confuse them behind parents' backs, and it's very concerning. And parents, please monitor your kids when they're online, because this is what happens. And I don't know, just every time I hear Edie speaking in a video, it just sounds like a script that his parents gave him to say. Because, you know, kids are terrible actors. I don't think Edie being happy in all of these videos is acting, but I do think everything he says is acting. And I don't know, that just kind of grosses me out. I wanted this video to be a little more serious today, because this is a very serious topic to me. This is about kids, and it's different than fat acceptance, because you can just change your weight and get away from that, but this, you can't just really change. I mean, you technically can just change your mind, but I think it goes deeper than that, because I don't know, I think it's just different, than fat acceptance. It's like a whole other arena because people really are oppressed as trans people. I don't think that some of their cries for help are completely ridiculous. I do think that they have some fair points and they are mistreated. But I think that they are, everything's being pushed too far right now. And I think it'll eventually settle down. Like, we just have to give it a few years. We have to ride this out. I don't know what to say about anymore, but Edie and Edie's father and family, if you ever see this, just know that I didn't say any of that to hurt your feelings. This is, again, just my opinion. I'm sure you hear it a lot, but just maybe take it to heart. I think it's really important for you guys to know that I just feel like kids, especially Edie, won't understand completely what it means to be trans, what like it all includes throughout the rest of your life, and to put it on social media and to just flip off all the haters, like, sounds like it would work, but you're also teaching your kids that anyone who might disagree with you doesn't have an opinion, they're just mean, and they're just doing it to be mean, because most people on that channel who watch, all the comments that I've seen are just, I'm so glad my parents weren't like that, I'm so glad I was raised right. At that age, I was like, why the sky was blue, you know? Like, that's what kids that age were like when I was that age. But now it's so different, and I don't think we should be including kids in this. I'm not saying that we should just completely shut down the kid whenever they have a question, but I don't think affirming a question that, or something that they're confused on, and just because they asked a question, or just because they wore something one day and they were like, oh, that was fun. It's a hard topic, and I'm sure I'm wrong about a lot of things, and I might not understand completely, but I have seen it firsthand. I have a sibling who is trans, so I think I'm allowed to talk about it. I am allowed to talk about it, and I'm allowed to have an opinion on it, and I'm allowed to voice that opinion. And I'm not gonna flip you off if you don't agree with me. I feel like I've been as respectful as I could be, because usually I'm pretty unapologetic about it, but this is about kids, and I know there's a lot of rules surrounding kids, so, and like, parents can do what they want. So I feel like I'm kind of repeating myself now, so I'll be done. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get to 500. I'm really hoping to get to 1,000. Maybe comment down below what you think about all this, because I don't think I'm alone in talking about this, but if you disagree, I would love to know why. I am sure that a lot of people will, but let's keep it civil, because I wasn't making an attack. I was just voicing my opinion. And yeah, so please take your meds if you haven't today. Please drink some water, eat, do whatever you gotta do to be healthy, and peace.